Our home planet, Earth, which we all live on, is easily recognizable with its blue sky, blue vast oceans, and largely green vegetation. Yet, what if I were to tell you that this also shows Earth, or even this, when much of Earth looks somewhat similar to Jupiter's moon Europa? All of these examples may seem like science fiction at first, but in actuality represent the likely appearance of our planet during portions of its 4.543 billion-year-long geologic history. This is why I have decided to highlight the five weirdest periods of Earth's geology. To start off this list, I am taking us back to 3.5 billion years ago during the early Archean period. The first thing you'd notice is that as far as the eye can see, the water-filled oceans are not blue, but instead, purple. These oceans contained a widespread presence of one of the first primitive life forms to develop. It happened to be a type of archaea which thrived in the absence or near-complete absence of oxygen and did not use chlorophyll like modern plants, but instead a purple pigment known as retinol to convert light into chemical energy. Retinol had a distinctive darker purple color, meaning our planet's oceans for a time were also purple. Going a bit further back to the early Eoarchean 3.9 billion years ago, we reach another period when Earth was unrecognizable from a modern point of view. From space, much of our planet appeared obscured, much like Saturn's moon Titan in the modern day, with much like being blocked by the orange-tinted sky. The reason the sky appeared orange was due to the high abundance of the gas methane in our planet's early atmosphere. When ultraviolet light hit particles of this methane, it caused the molecules to break apart into other hydrocarbons, and it was the interaction of light with these other hydrocarbons that caused the sky's orange color. But if we were to somehow see through this layer of haze, we'd see something straight out of science fiction. A water world with not a single landmass in sight. While the timing of the first plate tectonics is still uncertain, there almost certainly weren't any landmasses at this point in Earth's ancient past. Not only had plate tectonics probably not begun yet in the modern sense, but Earth contained twice as much water in its oceans than it does today. And the oceans during that period were not blue, but instead green, largely due to other primitive life forms known as cyanobacteria. Jumping ahead to 2.45 billion years ago, we reach a period when the supercontinent Kenorland existed, almost spanning the entire distance from the North to South Pole, but what was of greater note is that the contemporary oceans had a distinctive blood-red color. This is because after several hundred million years of being absorbed into the crust, all of a sudden the first massive influx of oxygen into the atmosphere began rusting all of the world's exposed iron minerals. This rusted material on land, which was then eroded into the oceans, eventually becoming iron 3, which had a distinctive red color. During what is known as the Great Oxygenation Event, much of this material eventually settled on the ocean floor, forming 60% of the planet's modern iron reserves via what are known today as banded iron formations. The newly released oxygen during the Great Oxygenation Event then reacted with an incredibly potent greenhouse gas, methane, to create two lesser greenhouse gases, causing worldwide temperatures to eventually plummet to an average of around negative 5 degrees Celsius or 23 degrees Fahrenheit. This marks our fourth weird period when 2.25 billion years ago, this widespread glaciation transitioned into the first of three slushball Earth periods. This caused glaciers to cover the vast majority of our planet's landmass, far more than during any part of the Pleistocene Ice Age, with only a narrow band of icy but not completely frozen water at the equator. A later such period caused even colder temperatures during the aptly named Cryogenian, which involved two additional slushball Earth periods. However, to me, the weirdest period of Earth's history happened during the Middle Ordovician period between 467.5 and 464.5 million years ago. As, while still highly theoretical and unproven, there's a chance that Earth had a planetary ring system during that time span. One explanation is that a large asteroid was captured by Earth's gravity as an extra moon and was eventually torn apart into many smaller fragments after passing within the Roche limit. Many of these fragments would later fall to Earth, but only at or near the equator via what is known as the Ordovician meteor event. These rings, if they ever truly existed, would later disappear as all of it eventually impacted Earth. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Tagir Varu, for supporting this channel.